Did the government pressure social media to censor Americans for saying things like natural immunity is real?
Absolutely.
Did the government pressure social media to censor Americans for saying things like gain-of-function research happened in that lab in China?
Absolutely.
Did government pressure social media to censor Americans for saying things like the virus likely came from a lab?
That is right within the heartland of our evidence.
Did government pressure social media to censor Americans for saying things like the vaccinated don't, getting vaccinated doesn't prevent COVID and it doesn't necessarily stop transmission of COVID?
Absolutely.
So all those were true statements. But according to the Democrats, it's fine for the government to pressure social media to take those statements down. In fact, this administration started doing that on day three, January 23rd, 2021. Here's what the suggestion, as Mr. Seligman says, the Biden White House said to Twitter. Clark Humphrey, Executive Office of President, White House office, hey folks, wanted to flag the below tweet and I'm wondering if we can get moving on the process for having it removed. Then in all capitals, ASAP. Is that a suggestion or maybe something a little stronger than a suggestion from the White House on the third day, of this administration?
Stronger than a suggestion.
Heck yes, it's stronger than a suggestion. And here's the scariest thing of all. The bulletin the Democrats put up earlier, the National Terrorism Advisory System bulletin for February 7th, 2022, talks about mis, dis, and malinformation. Mr. Sauer, tell me what is malinformation.
Malinformation, by their definitions, is truthful information that the federal official thinks lacks appropriate context. It's an Orwellian term.
So it's true, but the government says we don't want the people seeing that, hearing that, repeating that, liking that, sharing that. We don't want that to happen.
Correct.
Now, that is scary. That is exactly what the chairman just said. That is this dystopian, crazy world they want to go. And that's exactly what they were doing on day three. Because you know what the underlying tweet was? The underlying tweet said this: Hank Aaron's tragic death is part of a wave of suspicious deaths among elderly closely following administration of the vaccine. He received the vaccine on January 5th. True. Hank Aaron, true and real American, great American, amazing athlete, wonderful human being. He got the vaccine on January 5th to inspire others to get it, and then there's nothing false in that whatsoever. Nothing false. And these guys in the Biden White House said, take it down, but not just take it down. They said, take it down as soon as you possibly can. That, and Mr. Seligman, Mr. Professor of Law says, you know what? That's just fine. That is a scary, scary world that the Democrats want to take us to. And as you said earlier, if it was the other way around, if this was Republicans doing this to Democrats, you'd be just...